With the high price of fertilizers, especially potassium, it is important that we test the soil for this and other nutrients. Everything starts with taking a good soil sample. University of Arkansas recommendations call for a soil sample 4 inches deep for soybeans. A shallow soil sample may give an abnormally high potassium reading, as the nutrients tend to accumulate in the top few inches, especially on the reduced tillage systems. The sample is sent to the lab. The soil test report will show not only the concentration of potassium, but also a classification based on yield potential. In the example provided, the concentration of potassium is 92 ppm or parts per million. Such level is classified as medium. Phosphorus on the same report is classified as low. But what do we mean by medium or low? The table shows the interpretation of soil test levels for potassium. A potassium level of medium means that 85 to 100% of the yield potential will be obtained if no fertilizer is applied. A very low level means that less than 65% of yield potential will be obtained if no potassium fertilizer is applied. Next, fertilizer recommendations. The table shows the potassium recommendations according to soil test level for full season soybeans. As much as 160 pounds per acre are recommended if the level is classified as very low. A split application is recommended for this rate as it may aggravate soil problems in affected areas in the state. So don't guess, soil test.
Your Arkansas Soybean Podcast is a production of the University of Arkansas Division of Agriculture and was funded in part by the Arkansas Soybean Promotion Board. For more information on soybean farming in Arkansas, contact your local county extension office.